Hello, fellow explorers of the cosmos. It's the Tired Timelord here, embarking on another journey through the stars. Today, we're delving into one of the most iconic vessels ever to traverse the fictional universe of Star Trek, the Constitution-class Starship. This marvel of the interstellar engineering has captivated audiences for decades, standing as a testament to human imagination and ingenuity. In this examination, we'll explore the fascinating world of the Constitution-class Starship, uncovering its storied history both within the realm of Star Trek and in the real world where it was conceived. From the drawing boards of legendary designer Matt Jeffries to the far-flung adventures off USS Enterprise, join me as we unravel the secrets of this iconic spacecraft, understand its specifications, and appreciate its lasting impact on science fiction and space exploration. In this first segment, we turn back the pages of time to the genesis of the Constitution-class Starship, a journey that begins with the visionary mind of Matt Jeffries. Known for his exceptional talent and creativity, Jeffries wasn't just a production designer. He was a pilot and aviation enthusiast, bringing a unique perspective to the world of Star Trek. His career, marked by ingenuity and a pioneering spirit, led him to the bridge of one of television's most groundbreaking shows. As the primary designer of the original USS Enterprise, Jeffries' role in Star Trek was pivotal. His vision shaped not just a spaceship, but the very essence of a future where humanity ventured beyond the stars. Born Walter Matthew Jeffries on August 12, 1921, in Lebanon, Pennsylvania, he grew up during a time when aviation was rapidly evolving. His early interest in aircraft was more than just a passing fancy. It became a lifelong passion, one that would later deeply influence his work on Star Trek. Jeffries' career took a significant turn during World War II, where he served as a pilot in the South Pacific. This experience with aircraft, and more importantly, his understanding of their functional design, was crucial. He learned firsthand how machines operated under stress, how form followed function, and the importance of efficient design, principles he would later apply to the USS Enterprise. After the war, Jeffries pursued a career in art and design. He worked in commercial aviation but soon transitioned to film and television. It was here that his skills as an artist and his knowledge of aviation coalesced. When he joined Star Trek, he brought with him not only his artistic out as focal points. One of the most significant challenges was conveying a sense of motion, as the model itself was stationary. This was achieved through a combination of camera movements, lighting effects, and later, visual effects enhancements. The end result was a convincing portrayal of a massive starship gliding through the cosmos, a feat that had never been achieved with such realism on television before. The filming techniques and model construction of the Constitution-class starships set new standards for visual effects in television. It demonstrated that with creativity, ingenuity, and a bit of technological wizardry, the final frontier was within reach, at least on the small screen. This pioneering effort laid the groundwork for future advancements in sci-fi productions and remains a testament to the visionary spirit of the Star Trek team. As we warp into the second part of our journey, we delve into the in-universe lore of the Constitution-class starships. These vessels were the pride of Starfleet, representing the pinnacle of 23rd century technology and exploration spirit. But why did Starfleet commission this class? It was designed as a response to the growing need for exploration, defense, and diplomatic presence in deep space. A versatile vessel capable of meeting the diverse challenges of the final frontier. Measuring an impressive 289 meters in length, the Constitution class was a testament to Starfleet's engineering prowess. The ship's primary structure was its saucer section, with a diameter of 127 meters. This section housed the main bridge, crew quarters, and several key operational departments, making it the nerve center of the ship. Spanning across these two primary sections, the USS Enterprise featured 21 decks, providing ample space for the various functionalities required on a starship of its caliber. Below the saucer was the secondary hull, a cylindrical structure that contained the main engineering section. This is where the ship's heart, the warp core, was located, the power source that enabled faster-than-light travel. The secondary hull also housed the main deflector dish, crucial for navigating through space debris and other obstacles. Extending gracefully from the secondary hull were the two warp nutshells, a defining feature of the Constitution-class design. These long, cylindrical structures were equipped with the warp corals, necessary for creating the warp field, propelling the ship through space at incredible speeds. The nutshell's design was not just for aesthetics. It was a functional aspect of the ship's warp drive system. The Constitution-class starships boasted a crew complement of around 430, a mix of Starfleet officers and enlisted personnel. Each crew member played a vital role, from navigating the vastness of space to conducting scientific research and diplomatic missions. The ship's armament included phaser banks and photon torpedoes, providing both offensive and defensive capabilities. The phasers, energy-based weapons with variable yield settings, were located at strategic points on the saucer and secondary hull. The photon torpedoes, housed in the forward and aft torpedo bays, offered a more powerful option for combat situations. The Constitution class was also equipped with deflector shields, a protective energy field that could absorb and dissipate the energy from enemy attacks and space hazards. This shielding technology was essential for the survival of the ship and crew during their perilous missions. Beyond its technical specifications, the Constitution class was designed with the well-being of its crew in mind. The living quarters, recreational facilities, and medical bays were all designed to provide a comfortable and sustainable environment for long-duration space missions. Let's examine the variants and refits of the Constitution class. As seen in Star Trek, the motion picture, this refit was not just a cosmetic overhaul, it represented a significant technological upgrade, reflecting advancements in both the Star Trek universe and real-world visual effects. The sleeker lines, improved warp nutshells, and upgraded systems showcase the ability of Starfleet to innovate and adapt. In the Kelvin timeline, as depicted in the 2009 Star Trek film and its sequels, we encounter a different version of the iconic USS Enterprise. This Kelvin Constitution class is notably larger than its Prime Universe counterpart. The reason for this increase in size? It's a direct result of Starfleet's encounter with the advanced Romulan mining vessel, the Narada. The Narada's futuristic technology, originating from the 24th century, provided Starfleet with a technological leap forward. However, this sudden infusion of advanced technology came with a caveat: it wasn't immediately miniaturizable to the scale of the original Constitution-class designs. As a result, Starfleet engineers had to accommodate these advanced systems within a larger hull. This necessity led to the creation of a more massive and imposing starship, reflecting the accelerated technological advancements in the Kelvin timeline. Among the stars of the Constitution-class fleet, the USS Enterprise, under the command of Captain James T. Kirk, stands out as the most renowned. This ship's adventures, as depicted in the original series and subsequent films, captured the hearts and imaginations of millions. But the Enterprise wasn't alone. Other ships like the USS Constellation, USS Defiant, and USS Excalibur each have their own stories, contributing to the rich tapestry of Star Trek lore. The legacy of the Constitution class extends far beyond its own time. Its design and concept influenced numerous future Starfleet ship designs. This legacy is a testament to the lasting impact of the Constitution class. It set a standard for what a starship could be, both in terms of design and narrative potential. These ships were more than just vessels. They were characters in their own right, playing pivotal roles in the stories that unfolded around them. The fan reception of the Constitution-class starships was nothing short of phenomenal. These vessels became symbols of exploration, adventure, and hope. Fans embraced not only the technological aspects, but also the ideals these ships represented. The enduring popularity of the Constitution class is evident in its continual presence in fan fiction, models, games, and conventions. The USS Enterprise, in particular, is a cultural icon recognized even by those who are not Star Trek aficionados. Did you know that the registry number NCC-1701 was chosen by Matt Jeffries? Based on aircraft registration codes, with NCC standing for Naval Construction Contract. And that brings us to the end of our stellar journey through the legacy of the Constitution-class starships. If you've enjoyed this voyage through the stars and the stories of Star Trek, I have a small but important request. Please hit that like button if this video has engaged your inner explorer. It's a small gesture, but it helps this content reach more starship enthusiasts like us. Don't forget to subscribe to the Tired Timelord for more deep dives into the fascinating world of science fiction and space exploration. And if you know fellow Trekkies, space enthusiasts, or anyone who would enjoy this journey, please share this video with them. Spreading knowledge and passion is, after all, the Starfleet way. Thank you for your support, and remember, as we explore the mysteries of the universe, both fictional and real, the adventure is always more rewarding with fellow travelers. Until next time, keep exploring, and may the stars guide your path.